In an examination, two types of questions are asked, 1-mark questions and 2-mark questions. For each wrong answer of 1-mark question, the deduction is 1/4 of a mark, and for each wrong answer of 2-mark question, the deduction is 1/3 of a mark. So let's put it here, we have two types of questions, 1-mark questions and 2-mark questions, okay. So for this, and there are two possibilities, either the question is wrongly answered or it is unanswered, okay. So question says that if it is, if 1-mark question is wrongly answered, then 1/4 of a mark will be deducted. So penalty for 1-mark question is 0.25, which is 1/4 of a mark. And if it is wrongly answered, then the student will lose 1 mark for the question. So 1 mark for the question and 0.25 for the penalty. Similarly, for 2 marks question, the deduction is 1/3 of a mark. So penalty for 2-mark question will be 0.33. So 0.33 is the penalty, and because the question itself is of 2 marks, so for making like it, so if it is incorrectly answered, then total mark student will lose is 2.33. It says, the question says that half of a mark is deducted for any unanswered question. So irrespective of whether it is a mark 1 question or mark 2 question, if it is not answered, then half of a mark will be deducted. So 0.5 will be penalty in this case, and the mark for this question was 1. So in total, a student will lose 1.5. Similarly, for 2-mark question, penalty is 0.5 and the question is of 2 mark itself. So this is the mark distribution for wrongly answered and unanswered question. So now we have to look into all the possibilities that can occur. So the first possibility is, or the student who is ranking 1, who has done all questions correctly, has not left any question unanswered. So rank 1 guy will have, out of 30 marks, he has made 0 mistakes. So total marks he has got is 30. Okay. The second possibility is, out of 30, the student has committed least mistake. So here we see the mistakes are in the order of 1. So this is the least mistake. Then this could be the second least mistake. This is the third least mistake. And this is fourth least mistake. Okay. So the guy who has ranked second has done this mistake, like the least mistake, which is of 1.25. So score of this student will be 28.75. Okay. Similarly, the guy who is ranking third has done second least mistake, which is of 1.5. So this is 28.5. Fourth ranking guy has done third least mistake, so 30 minus 2.33 or 27.66. Okay. And the guy who has ranked 4 has done the fourth least mistake, which is 30 minus 2.5 or 27.5. So as per the question, we need to find out the guy who has scored 27.5, and all student has scored unique mark. So this is the answer. When a student has scored 27.5, the student has ranked 5, okay, in this case. So we had to try all the combinations. And other way could be, let's say if the mark for which we have to find out rank is even below the 27.5, then we have to go on reducing this. Okay. In this case, this is one time, like one question left or unanswered. If we had to go beyond this, in case the question was asked, if the mark is below this, then we have to repeat this for second questions. Okay. But here we have got this answer in the fifth step itself. So guys, this question was asked in XAT 2015 examination as well as in MHCET 2018 examination. So if you have any doubts or questions, you can post in comments. Thank you.